was a real success. We had 20 buddies sign up immediately, and in a class of about 30 to 40 pupils, that was quite a large percentage. And the scheme, I should also mention, involves combined honours students too, who often feel they're kind of in between departments, but they were fully invited to join our scheme as well. So after that, I finished off the buddy scheme handbook with Professor Esther Reed, who rigorously looked through and commented on every spelling mistake, which was really useful, and gave her input as well. So then after that, we wanted to make all of the new students coming feel really welcome and involved in the scheme from the very beginning. So Esther suggested that we sent a letter in the welcome pack, which I wrote out, and it's actually in the report if anyone has picked one up. And that just simply had information about the scheme and a little sign-up slip at the bottom, so they just had to bring that along on the first day. So then I spoke at the induction day, which was on Tuesday of Welcome Week, and the new students were quite nervous, and there were a lot of our second year students there, and we tried to come across really friendly and really promote the scheme. And actually nearly all of the first year students signed up to be paired with a buddy, which we thought was really encouraging, and it definitely showed that there was a gap for people to pair the year groups. So then after that, I randomly allocated the buddies, so the buddy groups were all created, and we had the theology party, which is quite infamous, on the Friday of Welcome Week. And I remember in my first year, it was very much the second years and the third years sat on one side, the first years looked nervous in the corner. But this year we completely mixed everyone up, everyone was put into their pair groups, and it was really encouraging to see lots of interaction between the different year groups. Okay, so with regards to like maintaining the scheme, I will admit I didn't realise how much work I'd actually taken on at the time. So it was quite simply just prompting the buddies to keep meeting up with their younger students. I really pushed for library talks, because that seemed to be a major thing. The library is such a massive building, it's really hard to know where your books are. So a lot of the buddy groups did meet up and organise like a library tour between them. So then it was just by emailing the students that we continued to emphasise the importance of the buddy scheme. I also supported my own buddy group and became really good friends with them, which was really promising. And also had meetings with Alex to discuss how to improve the scheme, and that's really helped with continuing it on next year. So as with all schemes, there have been kind of successes and challenges, and the theology department have been really helpful in pushing it forward and really encouraging me to keep it going, as well as the Change Agents Initiative, of course. So the promising news is that almost all buddy groups did meet up after the initial meeting. Some buddy groups met up once a aware of the initiative on the induction day in Fresh Speak. Within the letter, we have added a new section in which first years have the option to give their buddy their mobile number. This is a result of our aim to improve communication between first and second years. Buddies who have exchanged mobile numbers have kept in better contact and must be more successful because it has promoted an informal friendship. After meeting their first years, we will then allocate the buddies. In September, we will provide training for the second year buddies to give students information about the skills required and general confidence in the position. We have compiled regular questions that new undergraduates may ask the more experienced students, and we will also push the point of communication. We will encourage second years to text their buddies every other week, and if they know their buddies have an essay or exams, they should offer advice. They should also attempt to organise a coffee or campus mid-term. We admit that in some cases, first-year students do not need this additional service within the department. This is case-dependent and should not be initially encouraged by the team of students. We will give second-year students twice-term emails, and I'll give occasional notices and lectures. We have also organised extra events for the year. Ideas including a speed dating social. This will both be fun and result in initiating and deepening friendships with the department. Another prospect is organising a subject-related trip after general exams, in this case to the cathedral. This will give new students a refresher after exams with fellow theologians.
So we've really enjoyed leading the scheme and improving it and really crafting it, and we really hope that it will continue in further years, which I think is highlighted by the fact that a first year student has stepped up to lead next year. Do you have any questions?
How much do you think the success of the scheme is based on the relatively small number of students?
You've been asked this question, sorry, can you hear the question? Can you say that again, please?
So how much of the success of the scheme do you think is down to the small number of students in theology?
We have been asked this before, and I think it is great that we're a small department. It is easier to organise it, but it is more the keenness of the students that has led it. And the second and third years have really gotten behind being buddies, and the first year students clearly feel there's a need. So I think with regards to organisation, it would be harder with a larger number, but I think it could be just as successful with a large group of people, and you'd probably reach the rewards a lot more with the bigger department.
Certainly, drama do it, but they organise.
two second or third years working with four. So presumably that's done to prevent it being, as it were, too intensely kind of on. So does that maintain that? So do they always meet, as it were, as a collective group? Or because when you then went on to talk, it sounded slightly more as though it became more one-to-one, because I don't know quite how two people text four people, as it were. So how do you maintain that group element to it?
I think the group element actually did work quite well. It's quite easy. Most people have used like a Facebook group, which they put their whole body group in, and that again will be something we'll suggest next year in our training for buddies. I did a combination of the two with my buddies, so if they, for example, needed a bit more help, then I'd say, would you like to go for a coffee, just the two of us, or would you rather do it in the whole group? And that was really successful with some of the people in my group, but whereas others were happier to meet as a collective. So it is possible to arrange meetings, but I mean, it's only a group of six, and that's